Hello students, my name is Vuk, which actually means wolf. I'm a fourth year medical student, and I'm here to guide you through the entrance exam questions for the Medical University of Košice. I really hope that you will learn something. Good luck. Question 53 from biology. The plant cell differs from the animal one in that the former has A. mitochondria, B. plastids, C. ribosomes, D. vacuoles, E. rough endoplasmic reticulum, F. cell wall, G. lysosomes, and H. microtubules. So now, what do both plants and animals need? One of the things is to produce ATP for energy for various functions. And this is done in mitochondria, because mitochondria are the energy stations of cells. Apart from that, what else do they need? They need somewhere to synthesize proteins, a specific location, so ribosomes. These ribosomes, they're found in the rough endoplasmic reticulum, which also assists in other processes such as enzyme formation, and these are also found in both animal and plant cells. What else do they need? They need lysosomes because they need to be able to break down biological molecules. They need to be able to break them down so they can use them again or just so they can get rid of them. And lysosomes contain hydrolytic enzymes which allow them to perform this function. Apart from that, they need something to keep their general structure so that it doesn't just collapse, because cells are actually 3D structures and not just plain, and these are microtubules. Now, what do only plant cells need? Well, they need a cell wall so that when water enters, it prevents the cell from bursting. They need pigments for photosynthesis, because this is how plant cells get their food, and they need somewhere to store these pigments, and these are called plastids. Apart from that, they need a storage of food and somewhere where they can compartmentalize waste products, and these are vacuoles. So the correct answers are B, plastids, D, vacuoles, and F, the cell wall. I hope that now you understand why these answers are correct. Make sure to check out our other tutorials for biology and chemistry. And if you have any more questions or you need some clarification, please leave a comment below. Good luck and goodbye.